Good morning everyone, this is an English teacher and today we are going to study about a beautiful poem by Robert Frost, Dust of Snow. About the poet Robert Frost. Robert Frost was born on March 26, 1874 in San Francisco. He became interested in reading and writing poetry during his high school years. Frost drifted through a string of occupations after leaving school, working as a teacher, cobbler, and editor of the Lawrence Sentinel. His first published poem, My Butterfly, appeared on November 8, 1894 in the New York newspaper, The Independent. Robert Frost lived and taught for many years in Massachusetts, Vermont, and died in Boston on January 29, 1963. New words. Dust of snow. That means fine particles of snow. Then hemlock tree. It's a poisonous tree with small little white flowers. Now let us proceed with the explanation of the poem. Explanation, stanza 1. The way a crow shook down on me the dust of snow from a hemlock tree. In this stanza, the poet Robert Frost narrates his contact with nature in the form of the snowflakes falling on him from a tree. The poet was passing by a hemlock tree and a crow perched on the tree. When the crow moved, when the crow shook himself, some particles of snow fell on the poet. The poet is in a very pessimistic mood. He is in a very negative mood, very gloomy, very sad. That is why he's thinking about all the three dark things of life. First is crow. Crow is a bird that represents ill omen. That is considered to be unlucky. Even if you'll watch horror movies, you'll see a crow in that movie. And that crow will basically signify something horrible, something sad, something depressing. Second thing that the poet talks about is snow. Now, snow, we all love snow, that is okay. But snow is a very, snow represents a very dark season, that is winter. We cannot go outside and play. Even the evening comes very early and the nights are very dark and deep. So, second thing is snow, and the third thing is hemlock tree. I've told this to you before. Hemlock is a poisonous tree. It's a venomous tree. So, the poet is all being pessimistic and thinking about all the negative things of life. Crow, snow, and hemlock tree. So, I hope this stanza is clear. Explanation, stanza 2. Has given my heart a change of mood and saved some part of a day I had wrote. In the stanza, the poet Robert Frost reveals that the contact with nature was highly effective in soothing his gloominess, his sorrowful mood. When those tiny particles of snow fell on him, when he was passing by a hemlock tree, his mood drastically changed. He had been in a gloomy and foul mood throughout the day. But when those tiny particles of snow fell on him, he could feel happy. He was regretting too because of being sad, some part of a day was wasted. But now he's very grateful that he has turned happy and now he's going to enjoy the rest of the day. Those negative things, crow, snow, and hemlock tree, turned the poet's life into something positive. See, the concept of the poem is that everything is beautiful. Even the things that we think that they're unlucky or dark or depressing can be something very beautiful. It only depends upon the spectator, the one who's watching things. Let us talk about a black cat. Some of us consider it to be unlucky or something representing ill omen. No, that black cat can be very cute. You just have to play with it. It is truly said that beauty lies in the eyes of the beholder. So similarly, all those dark things, crow, snow and hemlock tree, turn something pessimistic into optimistic. So our poem is over. So now let us talk about the literary devices in the poem. First is alliteration. Alliteration means repetition of a consonant sound. In this poem, we have one alliteration, saved some. Then another literary device is enjambment. Enjambment basically means no punctuation mark. A person is portraying his feelings or his thoughts in one line, and that line is being written in a poetic form. If you see, there is only one full stop in the end of the poem. So it's a beautiful example of enjambment. Third thing is symbolism. Symbolism, see, crow represents ill omen. Hemlock tree, something very poisonous, that basically, poisonous means death. So it is representing death. And dust of snow means depressing, dull. So here we have three symbols in the poem. And rhyming scheme of the poem is ABAB. How to calculate the rhyming scheme? See, you always have to look for the last word of the stanza. Like, the way a crow. Crow. Crow means A. Then shook down on me. So the last word is me. Does me rhyme with crow? No. So me is B. Third line, snow. The dust of snow. Last word is snow. So does snow rhyme with crow? Yes. So here we have A again. Then from a hemlock tree. Tree. Last word is tree. Does tree rhyme with crow? No. Does tree rhyme with me? Yes. So it's AB, AB. Now, message of the poem. The poem Dust of Snow by Robert Frost reiterates that the little things in life can make a huge change in our future. It also shows that we can take the hard times of life in stride. Eventually, something will happen to change our situation into happier times. The simple things we do for others can make all the differences. Just think about those random acts of kindness we do and how much they brighten a person's day. And sometimes change their future also. Noticing and appreciating all the small things in life, we make our life happier. It will also cause us to have a spirit that is willing to change and therefore succeed. So this is the message of the poem. Key points of the poem. The poem describes a very simple event in very simple words. It tells that sometimes even a small incident may prove to be of a larger significance. Falling of snow, that is something very common. But it changed a person's mood. So that means even small incidents can have a deep impact. The poet is upset in the beginning of the poem. He is being negative, pessimistic. But a small incident of falling of snow changed his mood completely. He turned optimistic. In the end of the poem, the poet feels relaxed and thankful to the nature for saving his day from being wasted. So this is it. This was your poem. Thank you.